Hello guys, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, we are going to be creating this contact form here. Right, you got all this. So you can write your name in there, and then your last name, you got your email, and then your number in there, and then you can write your message. And then you will notice that once you click on this one, you got this box shadow outside here. And then this one, if you click on that, the block shadow is coming out of this and it's now in here. Or if you click in here, you got those box shadow there. So it's showing you where you are clicking in. And then you got this button with this hover effect as well. So yeah, and this message here, box, this message box here is adjustable, so you can adjust it. Right? So yeah, I'm excited. So before we get started, I just want to ask you that if this is your first time here, then please consider subscribing and smash that notification bell so you get notified every time we upload a new video. So yeah, with that being said, let's get started. So to get started, I already have my HTML file open up here. As you can see, this is my HTML structure. I also have my CSS, in which I already linked to my HTML. I'm also running a live server in my browser here. So just want to come into my HTML and start writing my code. So the first thing I want to create is a div with a class name of Ripper. So Ripper, just press tab there. And then inside this Ripper div, I want to create another div with a class name of contact. Contact there. And then inside here, I just want to create an h2. So inside an h2, I just want to say get in touch. Right, got your h2 there. And then I just want to create a header rule. So press tab there, and then I want to come down. Next thing I want to create is my form. So create a form, and then inside this form I want to create a div where I'm going to keep my input and label. So the first thing I want to create is a div with a class name of container. So container, right? And inside this div I want to create another div with a class name of input container, right? So and then just press tab, and then you got it right there. So not to confuse you, this container div, let me just add a comment here that this is where it ends. So add of container div, so this is where it ends, right? So now you are inside this input container div here. So we want to create a label, right? And then this label, you just want to say, let's say first name, right? First name there. Let me just enlarge this a bit so that you can see. Got it right there, first name. And then you want to add an input, right? An input, the type, leave it as a text. Don't want to give it any placeholder, so I just want to add a required. Right, you got that. So if you save and come in here, you see you got it right there. So if you wanted to add a placeholder, you can add a placeholder, let's say placeholder, and say first name, right? First name there. And then if you save, you see you got your first name there. But I don't want to add a placeholder because we already have this label up here, so I'm just going to remove this placeholder. Right, but you can add a placeholder if you want. It's definitely up to you. So just want to leave it like that. So now let's move on. The next thing I want to do is just I don't want to rewrite everything, so I'm just going to copy this and then paste it in here. So I'm still inside my container div there. I just copy this input container there and then paste it inside my container div there. Paste it down there. And then this one, I'm just going to give it a last name. Change it to a last name here, last name, right? And then paste that. So if you save, you see you got these two here. So now the next thing I want to do is copy this whole container div, this whole thing until here, right? Copy that and then paste it down. You are outside your container div there. Paste it down. So actually you are making two container div, right? So now in here, this one I want to change it to my email, right? And then this, I want to change it to phone, right? Save that, the label there. So now, once you see, you got it right there. You got this. So now, I want us to come out, right? I want us to come out there. So, and then create another input container div. So, input container. Input container there. So, and then in here, let's add a label again. So, this is going to be our message. So, and then I want to create a text area, right? A text area there, the row, let's just give it a row of 5, right? And then if you save that, come in here, you see, you got your text area there, which is adjustable, right? Got your text area there. So now, the last thing I want us to do, just come outside of this, and then create our last thing, which is a button. So just create our input, and then the type, I want us to make it a submit, since this is going to be our button. And then the value, they just say send inquiry, right? Save that. Come in here, you see you got your button there, right? Perfect. So this is all your HTML there. Let me just analyze so that we can see that. So this is all our HTML there. And yeah, that's all I want to do in my HTML. So let's jump right straight into our CSS. Just enlarge this. So now with this, just do this. So now I want us to come in here. The first thing I want to do is reset everything to 0. So just change the margin, set them to 0, and then set some padding. Going to set them to 0 as well, right? Save that. You remove all the margin and padding. Then the next thing, I want to target our body and our input, this input here, and then our text area here. So body, input, and then our text area, right? So with this, I just want to use a font. I want to change the font family. Font family, I want to use Poppins. Poppins is a Google font. So if Poppins is not running, I want to run sans serif, which is a building font. So Poppins is a Google font, and then sans serif is a building font, right? Save that. Then if you come here, you see your font has now changed to Poppins. That's because I link Poppins to my HTML here. So if you don't know how to do that, I did a video on this before, so I will leave that link in the description for you. So yeah, let's move on. Now, the next thing I want to come out here, the next thing I want to target is my wrapper div here, right? This wrapper div there. So just going to call that wrapper there. So with the wrapper, I just want to set the position. Position, I want to set it to relative. And then the next thing I want to do is just display. Display flex, right? And then the next thing, I just want to justify content, so to the center. And then I want to align item, align item center as well. And then the next thing I want to do is just give this a minimum height, let's say of 100 view, which is view height, right? And then I want to set the width, let's just set it to 100%. And then I want to set the overflow, I want to set it to hidden. And then let's just change the background. I want to use a linear gradient, right? So a linear gradient, the first one, I want to set the degree how it's running. And then the first color that I want to use is FA FA FA, and then the second color, which is whitish, and then the second color is blackish, right? If you save that, you come in here, you see you got it right there. Let me just enlarge that. You got it right there. Right? Perfect. So now, I want us to come out here. And I wanted to create a pseudo element of our wrapper here. Right? So, I just want to call that wrapper. No, it's wrapper. Let me just spell that. Wrapper. But, I want to create a pseudo element. So, before, right? The first thing, I want to create the content, right, the content. Just want to create this, leave it empty. And then next thing, I want to set the position. Position, I want to set it to absolute, right? And then the next thing I want to do is just set the width. The width there, let's set it to 400 for now. We're going to change that though. And then the height, I want to set it to 400 as well, 400 pixel. And then the next thing I want to do is just set the background. Background, I want to use the linear gradient, right? The first thing, I want to set the degree how it's running, so it's 120 degree. The second one, I want to use the color, which is 1ABC9C. And then the second color I want to use is, let's say, FF4500, right? If you save that, you see you got it right there, you got your box there. Now let's move on. So the next thing I want to do here is just set the Z index. As you can see, our form is behind it, so I just want to set the Z index. Let's set it to 1. And then let's just set the border radius. I want to make this a circle, so let's set it to 50%. Then save that. Right, you got that, you got your circle there. So now I want us to set it to the top. Let's just set it to the top, let's say to -100 pixel. And then I want to set it to the left to, let's say, -300 pixel. If you save that, you see you got it right there. Now the next thing I want to do, if you enlarge this, see you got it right there, right? So now the next thing I want to do is just come in here and then change this, the width to 1000, and then the height to 1000 as well. Save that. Then you see you got it right there, right? So your form is still behind there. So far so good. Let's just move on. Now I want us to, we are done with that. I want us to come down and then start targeting our form, where our form is. You know, it's inside this contact there, so we can move it forward. As you can see, it's behind here. So let's call that. Now just come in here and then call our contact there, right? So our contact, the first thing I want to do is set the position to relative, and then I want to set the z index. I want to, let's just set it to 10. So if you save this, you see your form has now moved forward here, right? Perfect. So with our contact, I just want to set a background. The background, I want to use 124775F. That's the color I want to use. So if you save, you see you got it right there. And then the next thing, just move on. I want to change the color. The color, I just want to use FAFA. And then the next thing I want to do is just give it some box shadow. Want to use some box shadow, let's set it to 0 0 20 pixel. And then I want to use the color of right gray there. And then the last thing I want to do to our contact here is just add some border radius, and I just want to set it to 10 pixel. So if you save that, see you got it right there. And then now the last thing I want to add here is just add some padding. So I want to give it some padding, let's set it to 30 pixel. So save that. You see you got it right there, right? Perfect. So now let's move on. So the next thing I want us to move on to, I actually want to create a pseudo element for our contact form as well. So just contact. So we want to create a pseudo. So before, right, so with this, I want to set the counter, just set it to that. And then I want to position it. Position, I want to set it to absolute, right? And then the next thing I want to do here, just set the width. The width, I want to set it to 150 pixel. Then I want to set the height. The height, I want to set it to 150 pixel as well. And then I want to set the background. So the background, I want to use a linear gradient, right? Linear gradient, I just say to, I want to set to the same color that I use here on the background, so I'm not going to rewrite that. I just want to copy this, right? Copy that, copy, and then just come down and paste it in here. Paste it in there. Oh, see, get in there. So let's just paste it there, and then I just want to change the degree to 150, right? If you save that, see, you got it right there, right? So now I want us to move on, and the next thing I want to do here is just set the border radius. I want to set it to 50%, and then I want to move it to the right. I just want to set it to 10 pixels, and then I want to move it to the bottom, set it down so to 10 pixels as well. If you save that, you see you got it down here. Alright, so now I want to change the opacity of this. So just set the opacity. I want to set it to 0.2. You can write 0.2 or 0.2, is the same thing. So now the next thing I want to do is just add a box shadow. I just set it to 0, 0, 10 pixel, and then I want to use silver the color. So save that. See, you got it right there. So as you can see, your form is behind it. So now I want to set the z index. The z index, they just set it to 1 for now. Save. So your form is still behind, but we are going to call it so that we can move it forward. But yeah, for now, just follow along. So yeah, that's what we created. But then I also want to create the circle like this, but I want to put it on top here. So instead of rewriting the whole thing, I'm just going to copy this whole thing here, right? Copy that and then paste it down here. Paste it down, right? And then just change before to after. Change before to after, and then I want to set the right. Remove right and then set it to left, and then remove bottom, set it to top, right? Save that. You see, you got it right there. Now I want to make this a bit smaller, so change the width to 100 and then set the height to 100 as well. Save that. You got it right there, right? Perfect. So yeah, you got it like that. So if you feel like you are getting value out of this so far, then make sure you smash that like button, and now please consider subscribing if you haven't subscribed already by now. So yeah, let's move on. Now the next thing that I want us to move on to is this h2 here, get in touch here. This text here, we know it's our h2. If you come in here, it's our h2, which is inside our contact div there. So just come down here and then call it. Let's call contact. And then we are targeting our h2, right? So with our h2, the first thing, I just want to set a font size. Font size, I just set it to 30 pixel, and then the next thing I want to just set the font weight. Font weight, since I want to bold them a bit, so I just set them to 700, and then I just want to move it up a bit. So I want to move some margin bottom. Let's set it to 5 pixel. And then the next thing I want to do is just give it a z index, let's just set it to 2, since you can see I want to move it in front of this circle here. So, and then the last thing I want to do here is just set the color. Just want to use the color. The color that I want to use is 1abc9c. Save that. See, you got it right there. Right, you got it right there. Perfect. Now the next thing that I want us to move on to is this header rule here, this line you see here. So as you can see, if you come in here, is this one here in our HTML here. So let's call that. Now let's come down here. You know, it's inside our contact, but this time is our header rule. So with the header rule, I just want to set the width of that. Let's just set it to 40 pixel. And then I want to set the height, let's just set it to 3 pixel. Save that. You see, you got it right there. Now the last thing I want to do is just set the background. I want to use FA, which is white there, and then save. Now you see, you got it right there, right? Perfect. So now let's move on to styling our form here. So we know our form is down here, this form here. So let's call that, you know, it's inside our contact, right? But this time we are targeting our form. So with our form, I just want to move it down a bit. So let's put some margin to the top there. So margin top, let's just set it to 40 pixel, right? And then if you save that, you see you have moved it down a bit here, right? So with the form, the next thing I want to do is just set the position. I just want to set it to relative, and then I just want to give it a z index. Let's just set it to 10. And the reason I'm giving it a z index is so that I can move it in front of this circle. Remember I told you, so give it a z index, save that, and then now you see your form is now in front, and then this circle here is behind it, right? Perfect. So now let's actually move on to styling our label and input here. So if you come in here, you know your label and input are inside a div called input container there. So let's call that. So first let's actually add some styling to our input container here before we move on to the label and then the input. So to do that, let's just come down here and then call that, right? Input, you know, it's input container, right? Make sure you spell that right. And then with this input container, I just want to set the position. I want to set it to relative, right? And then I just want to display them in a line block. I want to use in a line block. And then if you save this, see, you got them right that, right? But if you enlarge this, you see you got them in a line there, right? So now let's continue. So with this, I just want to set some margin to the bottom. Let's just set it some margin to the bottom, let's say to 20 pixel. And then the next thing I want to do here is just add some padding to this. So padding, I want 0 pixel to the top and bottom, and then I just want to add 10 pixel to the left and right. Save that. See, you got them right there, right? Perfect. Again, if you enlarge, you see they are in line there, right? So let's continue. Let's actually start our label now, and then this input part, let's start with our label. So we know our label is inside, let's call that, so input container. No, it's input container, but this time we are targeting our label, which is our name here, a label there, right? So the label, the first thing I want to do is just display them block, since I want them to be on top. As you can see, they are in line here, so I want to put them on top there. So I want to display them block. Then if you save, you see they are now on top here, right? Got that? Perfect. So now let's move on to the next thing. Next thing I want to do to this label is just give it some margin to the bottom. Just want to give it some margin to the bottom. Let's just set it to 5 pixel, and then I just want to set the font size. Let's just set it to 14 pixel. Save that. Then you see you got them right there, right? Perfect. So if you feel like you are getting value out of this, then please make sure you smash that like button, and please consider subscribing. So now you know, if you come in here, you see you have added, if you come in here and then this our input here, we added a required keyword there. So you see that your first name is required, but if people are looking at your form, there's no way they will tell that this form is required, unless they try to click the send, and then it will say like fill this form because you added a required. So but you at least have to add like a red dots here, which is indicating that everything that is in red is required. So to do that, I want to come here and create our label pseudo, right? So I just want to come down here and then call, we know it's input label, then we know it's label. So I want to come after, I want it to come after, right? And then this, I just want to set the content, right? So the content, I want to set it to this stars here. And then the next thing I want to set is just set the color. I want to give it a red color, right? And then the next thing is just give it some margin left. Since I want to move it some margin left, let's just say to 5 pixels. And then if you save, now you see you got these red dots here, right? So it's indicating or it's showing the viewer that now you have to fill this part, and then this part, right? So you see how it's easy to do all that, right? So yeah, if you feel like you are getting value out of this so far, then make sure you smash that like button, and now please consider subscribing if you haven't subscribed already by now. So yeah, let's move on. Now let's move on to starting our input here, right? So let's just come down here. We know they are inside our input container, and then this time we want to target our input, right? So the input, the first thing I want to do is just set the width. Just want to set the width, let's set it to 170 pixel, right? If you save that, you see you got them right there, right? And then the next thing I want to do is just add some padding. Let's just set them to 10 pixel, right? And then the next thing I want to do is set the font size. Let's just set it to 15 pixel there. And then the next thing, I just want to remove the border. I want to set them to none, right? And then I want to set the background. Let's just use this whitish here. And then the next thing I want to do is just set the border radius, let's set it to 20 pixel. And then the next thing, or the last thing I want to remove here, just remove the outline. So outline, I want to set it to none, right? And then if you save that, see, you got it right there, right? Perfect. Now you want to add, like, once you click inside here in any of these, you want to give it a box shadow. So I want to come in down here, just come down here and then call it, you know, it's input, right? I mean input container, and then we are calling our input. But you want, once you focus, once you click inside, you want to give it a box shadow, right? A box shadow of, I just give it 0, 0, 10 pixel, and then the color that I want to use is 1ABC9C. So save that. So now if you come in here, if you click in here, you see you got a shadow there, and then you got your shadow there. Now let's move on to styling our text area or our message box here. So we know it's our text area, right? If you come in here, you know this is your text area down here. So let's just call that. We know it's inside our input container, right? But this time we are targeting our text area, right? So with our text area, the first thing I want to do is just set the width. Just want to set the width. Let's set it to 380 pixel, right? And then the next thing I want to do here is just remove the border. So I want to remove the border, set them to none. And then the next thing, I just want to set the border radius. I want to set it to 20 pixel. And then I want to set the background. I want to use FAFA. And then I want to add some padding to this. So the padding, I just want to set it to 10 pixel. And then the last thing I want to remove here is just remove the outline. So set it to none. Then save. See, you got it right there, right? Now you want, once you click in here, you want to give it a box shadow the same as this one, right? So just want to come in, instead of rewriting, just have to come here and then copy this, right? Copy that and then paste it down here, right? You paste it down here and just replace this input here with a text area. This is your text area. Save that. Now you see, once you come in here, you see it got that shadow there the same as this one, right? You got that. Perfect. So now let's move on to styling our button here. bar and town here, we know it's an input. If you come in here, you know it's your input with the type of submit. So come down here and then let's call that. So with our button, we know it's inside our contact, and so it's form, but this time we want to target our input with a type of submit there. Alright, now want to this, the first thing I want to do is display it. Just want to display it block, right? And the reason I'm displaying it block is because if you come in here, you see it's displayed in line. You see it's in line here, is on this side, right? So I want to keep it down here at all times. So if you come in here, let's just bring up our text editor and then save that. You see it displayed in block, and then if you save, it's now down here, right? So I want to keep it down here at all times, displayed blocks there. So let's continue. Now the next thing I want to add here is just give it some margin to the left a bit, margin to the left to 10 pixels, and then I just want to add some padding. So some padding, I want to add, let's say, 10 pixels to the top and bottom, and then 30 pixels to the left and right. Then if you save that, you see you got it right there. And then let's move on. The next thing I want to do, let me just remove this, enlarge this a bit, right? So let's move on. The next thing I want to add here is just set the font size. Font size, let's just make it 14 pixel, and then I want to set the font weight. One way that I want to bold them, so let's just say 700. And then the next thing I want to do is just remove the border. So the border, I want to set it to none. And then the next thing I want to set the border radius. Border radius, let's set it to 20 pixel. And then the next thing I want to do is just remove an outline. Remove the outline, I want to set it to none. And then if you save that, you see you got it right there. So now the next thing I want to add here is just add a cursor. A cursor, I want to set it to a pointer, right? And then I want to set the background. Background, I want to use this color here, which is 1ABC9C9C, right? Then the next thing I want to do is just set the color, which is the last thing I'm setting. So you set the color to 12475 off, right? Save that. You see you got it right that. So you got your button there. So now you want, once you hover your button, you want to give it a shadow, right? So instead of rewriting everything, just copy this, right? And then come down here, paste it down there. But then you want, once you hover this, so you want to give it a box shadow. Box shadow, big shadow, you want to use 0010 pixel, and then the color you want to use 1ABC9C. Save that. See, you got it right there. Once you hover, see you got it right that. So let me actually enlarge this so that you can see the form that we just created. So we got your awesome form there. So you can type in here, type in there your email there, and then your number there, and then you can write the message, then you can submit. So you created your awesome form there. So yeah, that was it. That brings us to the end of this tutorial. I hope you find this video helpful. If you did, then make sure you give it a thumbs up, leave us a comment down below, and if this was your first time, then please consider subscribing and smash that notification bell so you get notified every time we upload a new video. So yeah, with that being said, I will see you guys in the next video. I'm out. Peace, love, and unity.